We burn out because we're just trying to earn the space we're taking up. We're trying to prove that we are worthy and that this isn't a hobby. Welcome back to my channel. My name is Tara East. I'm a writer, blogger, YouTuber, and the author of the mystery novel, Every Time He Dies. And in this week's video, I want to talk about creative burnout. Now, I've never experienced true, proper burnout, but I have been in close proximity to those who have. Burnout is the emotional, physical, and mental exhaustion that follows a prolonged state of excessive stress. We don't really talk about burnout as it relates to creatives specifically, but this type of intense fatigue is, of course, just as real for artists as it is for anybody else. As Joyce Carol Oates says, you need so much energy and encouragement to write. The act of writing can be exhausting. It really does take a lot of energy because you're creating something out of nothing. Gone are the days where the only thing a writer had to worry about was writing their novel. And in fact, I don't even know that those days ever actually existed. If you're developing a creative career, then your energy will be dispersed across multiple projects, responsibilities, and duties. You probably have a blog, a newsletter, courses you're developing, private coaching, speaking engagements, media appearances, platform maintenance, Amazon ads you have to run, hell, maybe you even have to research how Amazon ads work. If writing is your side hustle, then your plate is even fuller as you balance all of the above tasks with full-time work or study. When we list all of these responsibilities and actions like this, it's really easy to see how creatives can also get burnt out. And yet, few creative people talk about this. We all talk about being busy because being busy is glorified, but perhaps the bigger reason why people don't discuss this burnout is because creative exhaustion feels kind of unjustifiable. We're not saving lives with our art. Though I would argue we have all heard people say, this book saved my life. And of course, most of our stories aren't solving major world problems. So because of these reasons, we don't feel like we have the right to claim burnout because writing our stories isn't very serious. And here we arrive back at that old narrative of artist's guilt. Burnout happens for creatives in part because we're basically still fighting to be taken seriously. Speaking from my own experience here, sometimes I find it really difficult to stop working and to relax because I take my art seriously and I want others to respect that too. For that to happen, others have to see me working hard. Taking weekends off, socializing, or reading on the couch just aren't the types of activities that hardworking people do. Or at least that's the toxic narrative going around in my brain. There are so many issues packed into this mentality. Writing takes energy, and we only have so many good hours in a day. Once we go beyond that threshold, we really aren't producing good work anymore. And what's more troubling is that we're actually going into a deficit. Studies and anecdotal evidence show that when we go hard on one day, our productivity will be significantly less the following day because we've just tapped out our tank. In the pursuit of convincing others to take our art seriously, we work ourselves to the bone. Unfortunately, this only harms our art. It's difficult to produce good work when your tank is empty. What is even more problematic is that engaging in this loop strengthens the link between productivity and self-worth on a personal level, while keeping the wider narrative of hustle culture well and truly alive. Part of the reason why we work so hard is because we feel that creating art is selfish and indulgent. But if we can find a way to make writing a punitive activity, then others will be forced to take it seriously. Writing, like all creative pursuits, is a privilege. It is an activity that is reserved for people who are able or willing to take financial risk to pursue a dream. In some cases, they may have other sources of income, such as a full-time job or a spouse that keeps things afloat, But in other cases, it's just a matter of reducing costs, applying for grants, and taking on contract work. Writers need energy and support and resources to write. If you were a single parent working two jobs, it would be incredibly difficult to find time to write, because in addition to a lack of time and space, there is also a degree to which we need to escape the reality and responsibility of our lives in order to venture into another. The world doesn't need art the same way it needs food and shelter. And this is the crux of artist's guilt. And yet, art is a record. What remains of ancient civilizations is stories and artifacts, the remnants of culture. Art enriches our lives. Imagine if all the forms of art were suddenly removed from the world. No more music, film, theater, paintings, weird exhibitions, or pottery. Imagine a life without books. Pretty miserable, right? And yet, continual cuts to art funding communicates a very different message. Art isn't valuable. And this message is only underscored to a degree by new technologies, which have trained customers to expect products, services, and yes, art, to be free. And all of this plays into creative burnout. The world doesn't take art seriously, but we do, and we want to be taken seriously, which means we double down on work, we play into hustle culture, and we produce all the content we can, and most of it we give away for free. We push ourselves to do and create more, because there is always something else that we could be doing. We could write another chapter, write another blog, join another platform, respond to that DM, create an email campaign, an opt-in offer. It's endless. Now, self-publishing is a wonderful option for so many writers, and I'm so glad that it exists. But man, it's also a lot of work. And there is so much that you can do as a writer that you feel the pressure to do it. Writing for 2 or 3 hours a day is no longer enough, despite scientific evidence showing that this is the extent of our bandwidth. To put things into perspective here, all of the greatest minds in the world, those who work at MIT and NASA, typically do 5 hours of intense focused work a day. It is easy to fall into the trap of working 6, 8, 10, or 12 plus hours a day, even if most of the work you do is kind of hollow and meaningless. See, busy work. And yet, science shows that most people can only work for 1 to 4 hours a day. Writers and creatives put in these long hours and engage in this busy work as a way to justify their desire to create. And so we too can be rewarded for our productivity, which is pretty much the easiest way to get instant validation and gratification. While outsiders may think that art making is all glitter and Instagram flat lays, artists are just as prone to burnout as anyone else, maybe even more so, because we've got so much to prove. We burn out because we're just trying to earn the space we're taking up. We're trying to prove that we are worthy and that this isn't a hobby. Burnout could happen for multiple reasons. Maybe you're juggling full-time work and a family while trying to make writing your side hustle. Maybe you're a full-time writer who works for hire doing copywriting or editing as a way to fund your passion project. Or maybe you're a fiction writer who has to balance imaginary worlds against all of the self-promotion that you have to do in order to be successful. There is a fundamental guilt that underlays all of the arts, based off this idea that our work isn't practical, urgent, or needed. There is this belief that nothing would change whether we made our art or not, and that our time would be better spent doing the elusively worthy something else. So when we do rest, we feel guilty. We tell ourselves that writing isn't coal mining, that we don't need to rest because we haven't really done anything that exhausting. Also, we fear rest, because it sort of reaffirms this idea, particularly if somebody catches us, that writers are lazy and you're just laying around waiting for the muse to show up. And so we continue on. We work and we grind our way through writing projects and all of the stuff we have to create for our online platforms. But we also need to rest. Now, it can be a little bit dysfunctional to say that you need to rest in order to be productive later, but if this is the only way you can frame rest so that you'll actually do it, well, hey, it's a starting point. It's all well and good to think of luscious lists containing restful activities, but what's more important is that you actually identify what activities will refill your creative well and make you feel restored. Bubble baths may not actually do that for you, but completing a puzzle might. Binge watching a Netflix season is unlikely to refill your creative well, but going for a walk in the bush or doing a 10-minute breathing exercise actually might. One way to think about rest that I really love is the idea of an archer who is pulling back their arrow. In order to shoot forward straight and true and with as much efficiency as possible, you have to pull that arrow way back. Because everybody needs rest, even lazy, privileged writers. Now, I'd love to hear from you. Do you suffer from creative burnout? What is the relationship like for you between writing and rest? Or is this maybe an area that you feel like you kind of need to work on? Leave a comment below because I'd love to hear all about it. Now, if you'd like even more writing advice, you can of course watch the other videos on this channel, or you can head over to TaraEast.com and dive into the archives. While you're there, be sure to join my email newsletter, link is below, because when you do, I'll send you a free gift, yay! Plus, you'll receive a weekly newsletter every Thursday morning, Australian time, containing links to that week's blog and vlog, a little letter by me, some resources I've enjoyed that week, an inspiring quote, and some other goodies that I only share via email. Thank you so much for watching again this week, guys. I truly appreciate it. Stay safe, stay calm, and keep writing, because the world actually does need more books. I'll see you next week.